Okay, it's great to be back with you for another GoldSeek.com Radio Gold Nugget segment. Today's special guest, Bill Murphy from Gotta.org and La Metropole Cafe. Well, Bill Murphy is at the helm of the Gold Antitrust Action Committee, Gotta, with Chris Powell working on behalf of precious metals investors to help expose market manipulation. Welcome back, Bill Murphy.
Good to be here, Chris. Thank you.
Gold prices settled higher today, regaining a lot of recent declines with strong signs of accumulation in the charts as traders are betting that reduced restrictions on gold imports in India could help boost demand, with them lowering some of these import rules. Analysts are saying that this will essentially break the premium that we've noticed triple digits recently, and this could, of course, boost demand for the yellow metal. Any comments?
Yeah, well, I think that's in the market, and it's pretty much a given. India is a, you know, obviously a big gold-consuming country, and to make it easier for the Indians to buy gold, the better. And it's in the market, but what really is got me going is this the most extraordinary action I've ever seen in a market in 40 years. It's a joke. I mean, it's all about the gold cartel, nothing else. I mean, it's gold and then versus the physical market. Gold gets down to 1280, silver gets around 19, they go up, they've shot up in minutes. Then the gold gets above 1300, the gold cartel says no mas, they put up the sign, goes dead the rest of the day, goes right back down again. It's been going on 6 to 8 times now in a not too long a period of time, and I've never seen this before, and I think you're right about the accumulation. It's leading something dramatic. I think sometime this summer, the gold market and silver markets are going to explode as the gold cartel blows up. I think they're going through the physical supply that they've been able to use to suppress the prices.
I wonder if you could tell us what signs you're seeing of the cartel losing their grip on the market. We've talked about this on the show a lot of times, and we are starting to see some signs of strength in the market every time things get weak.
Big one that resurfaced the end of last week about the European Central Banks coming out 3 to 4 months ahead of time about their 5-year agreements to limit gold sales and so on. In that, they talked about gold stuff they were doing in the gold market without being specific, and they've never mentioned it before. And we think it's because they know that the S is going to hit the fan in the future, in the near future. And they're bureaucrats, and they want to get out and talk about that they were involved in the gold market all this time because we don't think that they have much gold left. And they've gone through it, and they want to cover their butts by being bureaucrats, letting people know, oh, well, we've discussed this in the past, and yes, we did mobilize gold and get it out there in the market. I mean, the big picture is we thought they were hitting the wall a couple of years ago when gold was up towards 1900, but they were gearing up to mobilize gold for one major attack, and there's various ways they did it, the gold out of the Bank of England and disgorging ETS. People know this. And they were able to absolutely terrorize the gold market the past couple of years. And we think this reaction, at least I'll speak for myself, every time gold gets down around 1282, and this violent moves back up time and time again, it says they are finally running into trouble. And, of course, you've got an option expiring next Tuesday. And we think, we mentioned it way in advance, that they would be protecting the $1,300 price because they probably had a huge amount of calls written in the over-the-counter market. And it's playing out. It just seems there's a number of other things that seem to say that things are falling apart on them. You know, the silver fix is going to fold in the summer. And it's just one thing after another that says they're in trouble.
Sounds to me like what you're saying is some European officials want to get ahead. They're trying to get ahead of this story to cover their backsides because they were giving out information to certain parties who shouldn't have been privy to that knowledge well ahead of raids in the gold market. If this sounds fantastic, we just heard today traders are under investigation for having knowledge ahead of the FOMC meeting well in advance of our benchmark overnight lending rate, the decision on the FOMC rates. And they were trading on this for over a decade, about 15 years, and there's going to be quite an investigation there. You're right. I mean, it looks like they're starting to lift the veil behind the scenes here.
Chris, the exact quote is, "The signatories will continue to coordinate their gold transactions so as to avoid market disturbances. In plain English, that's what God has been saying they've been doing for 15 years, is coordinating gold transaction to manipulate the gold price, in my terms. And this stuff is just prevalent everywhere. I would say, it's funny because they used the word conspiracy nuts towards us, or they used to way back when. And that's the way most of these people do business, whether it was Enron, Madoff, what you're talking about, the LIBOR scandal. And that's what they do to marginalize people like us that stumble onto the truth. And I think finally the physical markets are seizing up on them. And, of course, it may not happen right away. It never seems to. It always takes longer than you think. But this stuff smells like a pressure cooker that this market's going to blow up, and they're trying to figure out what to do.
Speaking of blowing up, you know, we're seeing more tensions in the Ukraine, and this is kind of that story, I think, still making the back pages. But according to my sources, this could be quite a big story in the years going forward and something that could spark considerable geopolitical uncertainty in that region. And I wanted to get your take on what's going on there in the Ukraine and whether or not you see this as being an important factor for gold accumulation in the years moving forward.
What God knows, so do the Chinese. So I've explained that a number of times. They can pull the plug in the gold market anytime they want and create all kinds of havoc. Who knows what they're going to do there? But the Ukraine thing, yes, it obviously can be a big, big deal. Who knows what can play out? All I know is on a day-to-day basis and short term, the worse it gets in the Ukraine, the more the gold cartel steps on the price. Today there was an announcement about all kind of murders over there or something. The gold dropped $10 on the news. I've never seen gold hold a gain on an international crisis in 15 years. Not one time. Never. Because they know that people then, they don't want people looking at gold when they have an international crisis. The price goes up and they make sure they take it right back down again. I mean, it may go up eventually again, but that's, they never want it to be associated with the crisis.
And this, I think, is emblematic of what we're seeing there. I think we should also remember that, you know, Russia, huge, actually the world's largest exporter of oil. Many folks think of Saudi Arabia, but it's actually Russia that's just slightly ahead in their oil exports. And I'd also add that there was a big Russo-China oil deal made this week that I think knocks another pillar out from under the U.S. petrodollar hegemony. Are there any other stories that you're watching today? Any other news you'd like to share with the listeners?
Yeah, I want to emphasize this price action, how extraordinary it is, and that, you know, that it's, I've never seen it do this before over a short period of time. When you put it together with all these things you're talking about from a fundamental reason, I mean, it's all one-sided for gold and silver to go bonkers. I mean, if gold, I mean, simplistically, it kept pace with inflation, it would be double the price it is today. They, I mean, this gold cartel has gold and silver at artificially low prices that cannot be sustained. And if they've gone, the main key to the whole market is what they're able to do with their physical supply of gold from central banks and how they mobilize silver. If they're hitting the wall on that, and you've had negative GOFO rates, and you've had all kinds of signs that they are having trouble, gold and silver are going to explode out of nowhere, and the moves up will be volatile and violent.
With negative sentiment now reaching levels we haven't seen in years, I mean, you can suppress markets easily because people have just simply tossed up their hands. They've given up hope. These markets can remain subdued even when, as you say, they should be flying much higher.
Absolutely. And, it's, and of course, the dichotomy, it's lasted for some time now between the shares and the precious metal shares and what's going on with the NASDAQ and the Dow and other stock markets. It puts even more pressure on our sector because money managers have to get rid of investments in our sector because they have to maintain performance, and people are getting disgusted and saying, why am I doing this? And it's been very effective. And you're correct. The sentiment is as bad as I've ever seen it. Of course, that sets up something out of the blue, which is going to have it go bonkers. But for the time being, we're still in the weeds.
No, exactly. And as you say, just as markets gain momentum on the upside due to the derivatives and options and all the leverage out there that can be deployed by very large institutions with deep pockets, so we can see the same on the downside. So I think we will see, as Jim Sinclair has pointed to and alluded to for over a decade now, that as this gold market matures and we might be entering that third big stage here, we will see 100 point, 200 point or more moves on the upside eventually, don't you think?
Smart as they come, and he's going to be right. predicting anything in the very short term is nearly impossible, because these guys, this gold cartel, as we call them, they come out with these, and that's another sign, by the way. They've been coming out every other day with a flash crash attack where they might take down gold down anywhere from $5, $6, $7 to $15, and do it in minutes with many tons of gold hitting the market at once. They're seeming to have to resort to this tactic over and over again, and it hits the lower price level, and then, boom, we spike right back up again. So it's an extraordinary war, what I call the gold war, between this gold cartel and the physical market, which is beginning to seize up on them.
I wonder if you could tell folks more about the interesting services that you provide at La Metropole Cafe.
Well, people can sign up at gotta.org. It's a free list that Chris Powell, my colleague, does a great job with. And I have a website since 1998, La Metropole Cafe, and listeners can sign up for a two-week free trial and see if it's of value.
Well, Bill Murphy, we appreciate your thoughts, as always, staying on top of these markets for us.
Thank you, Chris. Good day.